Good morning students, good morning to all of you. So today in this class we are going to discuss about the construction of hyperbola by eccentricity method or focus directrix method or general method. So whatever it is. So the main topic name is conic section. So unit 1, class 8. So in this class we are going to discuss about these topics: hyperbola, how can we get the hyperbola, general diagram of ellipse, parabola, hyperbola, practical applications of hyperbola, construction of hyperbola by eccentricity method or focus directrix method. So these are the topics. So first of all, so how can we get the conic sections? Already we have discussed in the last class about the conic sections. So how can we get the conic sections? So depending upon the position of the cutting plane, so we have four types of conic sections. They are circle, ellipse, parabola, hyperbola. So these are the conic sections. So how can we get the hyperbola shape? How can we get the hyperbola shape? See here. So this is a right circular cone. This is a right circular cone. So this is a hyperbola shape. So if this is the axis of the right circular cone. See here. If we cut this right circular cone, if we cut the right circular cone with the help of cutting plane DD. So when the DD makes an angle, smaller angle, when the DD makes smaller angle with the axis of the right circular cone, then the obtained section or obtained shape is called hyperbola shape. Once again listen. See here, how can we get the hyperbola shape? If we cut the right circular cone with the help of cutting plane DD, that is the name of the cutting plane. When the cutting plane makes a smaller angle with the axis of the right circular cone, so then obtained shape or section is called hyperbola. For hyperbola, eccentricity value should be greater than 1. Eccentricity value should be greater than 1. See here, this is our right circular cone. So if we cut this right circular cone with the help of cutting plane, see this is the DD cutting plane. So DD is the cutting plane. So here the DD making an angle, smaller angle with the axis of the right circular cone. So then whatever the shape or it, whatever the section we obtain, that is called hyperbola. That is called hyperbola. So I hope you understand. Next, let us see general diagram of ellipse, parabola, hyperbola. So this is the general diagram of the ellipse. This is a general diagram of parabola. This one is the general diagram of the hyperbola. See here, this is a vertex point. So how can we define the vertex point? How can we define vertex point? Means, see here, this is a conic. Conic is nothing but what? Curve. Conic is nothing but curve. So here, the conic, the point where the conic cuts its axis, that is called vertex point. Once again, listen, the definition of the vertex point. Once again, listen, the definition of the vertex point means the point where the conic cuts its axis. See here, this conic, this hyperbola conic is cutting this axis line at this particular position. So that point is called vertex point. That point is called vertex point. So see here, this is a locus point of hyperbola. So P, the distance of the PF distance divided by PD distance gives the eccentricity. PF divided by PD gives the eccentricity. So this value should be greater than 1 for hyperbola, less than 1 for ellipse, equal to 1 for parabola. Okay. So this is about a general diagram of the parabola, ellipse, hyperbola. So this is a directrix line. Fixed straight line is called directrix line. Okay. Next, practical applications of the hyperbola. Practical applications of hyperbola. See here, the hyperbola shape is used in the design of cooling towers, in the design of cooling towers, hydraulic channels, electric transmitters and receivers, electric transmitters and receivers like radar antennas. So these are the some of the practical applications of the hyperbola shape. See, cooling towers. So generally we see these towers in the thermal power plants. These are called cooling towers. So generally we see in our Telangana, K KTPS, Kottagudam Thermal Power Station. Kottagudam Thermal Power Station. These are the cooling towers. Next, hydraulic channels. See, here, this is a hydraulic channel, canal. So, this shape also, hyperbola shape. Next, radar antenna. Okay, so antennas. So, this is also hyperbola shape. So, these are the practical applications of the hyperbola shape. So, let us see problem. Problem. Construct a conic when the distance of any point P, this is a locus point P, between focus point and directrix line is constant and is equal to 3 by 2. Once again, listen. Construct a conic when the distance of any point P between focus point and directrix line is constant and is equal to 3 by 2. So, name the curve. Name the curve. That is the question. And also draw the tangent and normal line at any point on the hyperbola curve. The focus is located 50 mm away from the directrix line. So, here this is the given problem. So, what is the given data? Focus point distance is given. That is 50 mm. Okay, focus point distance is given. So, focus point is located at a distance 50 mm from the directrix line. And what is the eccentricity value? Eccentricity value of the hyperbola is given. That is 3 by 2. It is greater than 1. So, that's why it is a hyperbola. If the eccentricity is greater than 1, that is hyperbola. If eccentricity is less than 1, that is ellipse. If eccentricity is equal to 1, that is parabola. In this problem, eccentricity is equal to 3 by 2. It is a greater than 1. So, that's why the name of the curve is called what? Hyperbola. Name of the curve is called hyperbola. So, let us see. Methods of hyperbola. So, generally we have three methods for constructing the hyperbola. So, they are eccentricity method or focus directrix method, first method, and second one is rectangle method. Next, third one is asymptotes method. So, these are the three methods. So, sorry, this is not number four, this is three. Okay, basically we have three methods for constructing the hyperbola shape. So, but our syllabus point of view, we have only one method, that is eccentricity method or focus directrix method. So, let us see how to construct an hyperbola, how to construct a hyperbola by using focus directrix method or eccentricity method or general method. So, after constructing the hyperbola, the answer part will be like this. This is a hyperbola shape, red color shape. So, this is open curve. After constructing, it will be appear like this. So, first let us see construction procedure of the hyperbola. Construction procedure of hyperbola by using focus directrix method or eccentricity method. See, construction procedure. First we need to draw any vertical line DD as a directrix line. Okay. Second point, mark a point C on the directrix line. So, third point, from the point C, draw the axis line which is perpendicular to directrix line. From the point C, we have to draw the axis line that should be perpendicular to your directrix line. And fourth one, mark the focus point on the axis line. So, focus point distance is given, that is how much? 50 mm distance. Next, fifth point, divide the CF into fine number of equal parts. Why? Because eccentricity value is 3 by 2. If we add the numerator and denominator of the eccentricity, we get the fine number. So, that's why we need to divide the CF into fine number of equal parts. Next, sixth point, mark the vortex point at point 2. Okay. Next, seventh point, from the vortex point V, draw the perpendicular line. from the vertex point B, draw one perpendicular line VB such that VB should be equal to VF, and join C and B and extend it. This is the seventh point. So all of you remember these points while constructing the hyperbola shape. All of you remember these points. These are the very, very important. According to these points, we will construct the hyperbola shape. So next, eighth point, from the vertex point B, mark approximately equal parts, on the axis line, say 6 or 7 as your wish. You can take 6 points, you can take 7 points, you can take 8 points as your wish. So it may be 6 or 7 parts. Next, ninth part, draw the perpendicular lines through the line, through the points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We need to draw the perpendicular line from the these points. Next, the 10th point, these lines means, perpendicular lines meet the CB line at 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash and so on, 6 dash. So now 11th point, F as a center, 1 dash as a radius, draw the arcs on both sides of the axis line. So we will get one intersecting point, that is P1. Above the axis line, we get intersecting point P1. Below the axis line, we get intersecting point P1 dash. Okay. So repeat this 11th step for all radius 1 dash, 2 2 dash, 3 3 dash, 4 4 dash. So we get the intersecting points P1 dash, P1, P2, P3 and so on, P6, P1 dash, P2 dash and so on, P6 dash. So if we join all these points, P1, P2, P3 and P1 dash, P2 dash, P3 dash and P6 dash. So we get the, hyperbola shape. I hope you understand. So let us see how to construct a hyperbola according to this procedure, So according to above construction procedure, we get the hyperbola shape. So draw the smooth curve to the points P1, P2, P3 and so on, P6, P1 dash, P2 dash and so on, P6 dash. We get the required curve, that is hyperbola. Okay. So let us see. So how to construct a hyperbola by using these points. Okay. See here. So according to construction procedure, so first, what is the first point? First, draw any vertical line DD as a directrix line. First, we need to draw any vertical line as a directrix line. This is a vertical line. So this is a vertical line, that is directrix line. First, we need to draw any vertical line as a directrix line. Okay, this is a DD directrix line. Next, second point, mark a point C on the directrix line. Third point, from the point C, draw the axis line. So this axis line should be perpendicular to your directrix line. Okay, this is a third point. Next, fourth point, mark the focus point. Mark the focus point F on the axis line. Such that, what is the focus point, distance? So focus point distance is given, that is how much? 50 mm distance. So this is a CF is nothing but 50 mm distance. Next, fifth point, what is the fifth construction procedure? Divide the CF into fine number of equal parts. Why? Because the eccentricity value is what? How much? E is equal to 3/2. So if we add the numerator and denominator of the eccentricity value, we get the 5. So we need to divide the CF into fine number of equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4 and this red color point is 5. Okay. Divide the CF into fine number of equal parts. Why? Because if we add the numerator and denominator of the eccentricity, we get the 5 number. So that's why we need to divide the CF into fine number of equal parts. Next, mark the vertex point V at point 2. So at this particular position, we have to mark the vertex point. So why? Because here eccentricity value is how much? 3/2. So here 3 indicates, so we have to count the points from the focus point. This is 0, 1, 2, this one is 3. Okay, from right side to towards left side. So below number, denominator is what? How much? Denominator is how much? 2. So we have to count these two number from the point C. So this is 0, 1 and this one is 2. So where these two points meet, so that is our vertex point. So we have to mark the vertex point at point 2. Okay, so that is the 0.6 construction procedure. And seventh point, draw any vertical line from the vertex line. See here, from the vertex point, draw vertical line. Draw vertical line. This is a vertical line. So this is a vertical line VB. So VB should be equal to VF. VB should be equal to VF. And join C and B and extend it. Join C and B and extend it. So next, eighth construction point, from the vertex point. So here, from the vertex point V, mark approximately equal parts on the axis line. On the axis line, see, this is 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, I'm taking 6 points. Okay, I'm taking 6 points. 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, next, ninth construction point. So according to ninth construction point, we have to draw the perpendicular lines. We have to draw the perpendicular line from point 1, from point 2, from point 3, and so on, point 6. Draw the perpendicular lines from point 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6. So these perpendicular lines will meet your CB line at 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, and 6 dash. Now, F is a center. 11th construction point, 11th construction point, F is the center, 1 dash is the radius, 1 dash is the radius, draw arcs on both sides of the axis line. Similarly, take 2 dash as radius, take 2 dash as radius, take 2 dash as radius, again F is the center, focus F is the center, again draw the 2 arcs on both sides of the axis line. And similarly, with the 3 dash radius, F is the center, again draw the arcs. Similarly, 4 dash is the radius and F is the center, 5 dash is the radius, F is the center, and 6 dash is the radius, F is the center, again draw the arcs on both sides of the axis line. You will get arcs like this. So this is P1, this is P2, P3 and P4, P5, P6, and below P1 dash, P2 dash, P3 dash, P4 dash, P5 dash and P6 dash. So if we draw a smooth curve from here, from the vertex point, draw a smooth curve through these points, through P1, P2, P3, P4 and so on, P6, P1 dash, P2 dash, P3 dash and so on, P6. So we get the hyperbola shape. This is a hyperbola shape. Red color. So next, we have to construct the normal line and tangent. Normal line and tangent. See here, for that, so on this hyperbola curve, you can take a point anywhere. You can take a point on the anywhere on the hyperbola curve. So I am taking here. So this is M point. Join M and F. Join M and F. Okay. So for this MF line, draw the perpendicular line. Draw the perpendicular line. So this is M point, this is F point. For this MF point, MF line, draw one perpendicular line. So this perpendicular line will meet your directrix line at particular point, that is T. Join T and this is starting point, M point. So you will get the tangent. Join T point and M point. That is a green color line. So this is our tangent line. So for this tangent, draw the normal line. So black color line is normal line. So this line should be perpendicular to green color line. Normal line should be perpendicular to tangent. Okay, so I hope you understand. I will explain this hyperbola again with the help of drafter.